Hello, I'm Alisha Jamal, and I'm one of the pediatricians at Trillium Health Partners. So, when should you bring your child to the emergency department? This is a common question that we get, and I will take a couple minutes just to go over things to look out for. So the first is if your child has any alterations in their level of consciousness. What I mean by that, if they're really sleepy, difficult to wake up, extremely irritable, won't stop crying, those are reasons to get assessed. The second reason is if you notice that your child is having shortness of breath. So things like flaring of the nostrils, or tugging here, or the ribs moving in and out quickly, the belly moving quickly, or if you notice some blueness around the lips, those are concerning features. We would be happy to have you seen in the emergency department if that occurs. So the third reason to bring your child to the emergency department is if they're severely dehydrated. You've tried to give some small amounts of fluid at home, either with a spoon or with a syringe, and they're really not drinking, or they're vomiting so much that they're not keeping anything down, or very sleepy and difficult to wake up, those are reasons to come to the ED for an assessment. The fourth reason to come to the emergency department is if your child has a fever for more than 5 days and looks unwell, so they have some shortness of breath or are very sleepy, those would be reasons to go to the emergency department. However, if your child looks well but continues to have a fever for about 5 days, I would recommend seeking a medical professional's opinion. That could be like your family doctor or a walk-in clinic. There are other places outside of the emergency department where you can seek care. Places like your family physician office, a pediatric cough and cold clinic, or an urgent care or walk-in clinic.